Gillette, the best a man can get.
Welcome in to First Things First. I'm Sarah Kustak, filling in for Jenna Wolf. That's Chris Canty. That's Chris Broussard, filling in for Chris Carter. Nick Wright, ready for a good week, guys?
I am ready.
I'm ready to get after it. CB already and I had a good conversation right before we even came.
I don't want to tell
so
what's happening.
So we're ready to go right now.
We're going to need to calm you guys down right out of the gate. But here we go.
No, we got
to
turn up. Don't turn down.
Right.
Turn
okay. up. That's All right. right.
Let's go.
It's All right, then let's turn it up. Here we go, because there's a lot to turn up on another day, and there is some more drama surrounding Raiders wide receiver Antonio Brown. Yesterday, Brown was not at Raiders training camp because he is reportedly still unhappy after the NFL rejected his preferred helmet for clearance in games. And it seems as though general manager Mike Mayock has had enough.
Here's the bottom line. He's upset about the helmet issue. We have supported that. We appreciate that. Okay, but we've, at this point, we've pretty much exhausted all avenues of relief. So from our perspective, it's time for him to be all in, we're all out, okay? So we're hoping he's back soon. We got 89 guys busting their tails. We are really excited about where this franchise is going, and we hope AB is gonna be a big part of it starting week one against Denver.
All right, Canty, so what do you think? Do the Raiders regret dealing for AB?
I'm not going to say they regret dealing for him right now, but I will say that when somebody shows you who they are, you better believe them. And we found out exactly who Antonio Brown was last year in week 17, no show, no call, when his team was fighting to get into the playoffs, playing against a division rival, and you can't be there for your teammates. That's the part of it that I can't excuse. I can understand his frustration with the helmet issue. The helmet is the most important piece of equipment that any NFL player will wear. But that being said, you have to work with the league office and you have to work with your team to be able to find a reasonable solution that everybody can live with. And right now, it just doesn't feel like Antonio Brown is doing that. He didn't accept the decision from the independent arbiter when they took that case to that court a couple of weeks ago. And now it's a situation where it's starting to become contentious with the organization that gave him the guaranteed money that he was looking for in a contract extension. Keep in mind, that's an organization that he hadn't done anything for. Okay, they gave him that money. And so now I think it's in a situation where Mike Mayock and John Gruden are starting to become adversarial because of the timing of it. We're talking about kicking off the regular season in a couple of weeks, and he's not there. That part of it is inexcusable, in my opinion.
This is absolutely ridiculous. I mean, they have to regret it. I'm sorry. You said we saw who he was last year. We're seeing who he is now. They want to set a culture. Okay, you got a lot of young players on that team, on the offensive end and defensive end. Josh Jacobs, the running back. Hunter Renfrow, the receiver. You want to set the culture, a winning culture. If you don't handle this correctly, then you could lose that locker room. You could lose your chances of establishing a strong winning culture in Oakland, which is what they're trying to do. So I think Peter King from NBC Sports, he wrote a great article where he said that the Raiders need to send the dreaded, as he called it, five-day letter to Antonio Brown. Okay, what that means is that they send him and his agent, Drew Rosenhaus, a letter saying if you're not here within 5 days and ready to practice and play, then we will put you on the reserve / left squad list, which means you cannot play for any team in the 2019 season. I think it's gotten to that point, Chris, because it's not only the helmet, there are the feet. Okay, then there are the reports that you're sitting in meetings. You've been late to meetings.
Derek Carr is the guy, and I think that 2019 is that season. Keep in mind, after this year, there's not a lot of guaranteed money on Derek Carr's deal, so the organization theoretically could move on from him. But when you bring in a proven commodity like Antonio Brown, he helps you to answer that question. Think about some of the other moves that they made this offseason. You mentioned drafting Josh Jacobs out of Alabama with the first-round pick, Hunter Renfrow. They also went out and signed Trent Brown from the New England Patriots in free agency. They're starting to Tyrell Williams from the Chargers. They brought him in as well. They're putting pieces on that offensive side of the ball to try to figure out whether or not they got a quarterback. I think that's the question that they have to answer before they can go about the business of worrying about the culture that they're trying to put together for this team moving forward.
Because isn't this to be expected with Antonio Brown? I mean, you said it, when someone shows you who they are, you understand this is part of what you're getting along with the talent of Brown. So when AB, if he does get back on the field, could a lot of this be diminished given how he can produce and what he can do in his impact when he's actually playing?
Look, he's a great player, and Mayock and Gruden said this. Being in the media, they got to see him in practice. The reason they took the risk was because they saw how hard he worked in practice, which was as hard as any player they've ever seen. So I get that. When he gets on the field, and if he produces, a lot of this could be forgotten. But here's the thing. Pittsburgh didn't win the Super Bowl with him. And Pittsburgh, with all his production, was ready to move on from him. So I don't know that he's going to be worth the headache. And I agree with you on the Derek Carr situation. But if he's creating problems, and he did it with Ben Roethlisberger, it's going to still be hard to see where Carr is if you got a receiver with a bad attitude.
Yeah, if he's disgruntled and disruptive, it makes it a little bit tougher to evaluate everybody on the roster. I get exactly what you're saying. But, I mean, I think this was a risk that Mike Mayock and John Gruden had to take. We know what Antonio Brown is in terms of a personality, but we also know what he is in terms of production on the field. Now, the fact is he ain't missed no games yet. It's a bad look. They're breaking training camp today. The other 89 guys, they've been working for the past month. It doesn't feel like AB has been doing much of anything rather than bumping his gums and talking about how disgruntled he is at the NFL. Now, to his defense, it feels like the NFL is moving the goal line a little bit on this helmet issue just because Antonio Brown did find one of the helmets that he's used to wearing, a model that was made within that 10-year window, and yet the NFL said that he's not going to be allowed to wear that one either. So when you look at the entire situation, there is a little bit of an issue in terms of the communication between the league office, the club, and Antonio Brown in terms of what the standard is for the helmet that he needs to wear in 2019.
Here's the thing, Chris. Over 2,000 players in the league, all of them have agreed to the helmet deal. Now, some of them didn't like it. You know, what was it, 32 other players last year playing their own
helmets?
33
guys, they were grandfathered in.
Right. Yeah. Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady, they don't necessarily like it, but they're doing it. Why can't Antonio Brown just do it?
He's going to end up doing it. That's going to end up happening. Antonio Brown is not crazy. There's still about $30 million in guaranteed money that's left out there. He's not going to leave that on the table because you're right. With the designation that the club that has the potential to put on him, the reserve left the squad designation, I mean, essentially, if he doesn't report in those 5 days after they notify him and his representation, they could actually void his contract, and that $30 million goes away.
He would lose.
So he's not crazy. He's not going to lose that money.
Should they send the letter?
Well, here's the thing. If you do send the letter, at that point, the relationship becomes contentious between Antonio Brown and the Raiders. And John Gruden
is not there yet.
Well, they've been trying to put a good face on it. John Gruden has come out in support of it.
But yesterday, Mayock, I agree with you, but Mayock came out yesterday pretty strong.
He did. We'll see what happens. I say he shows up.
It reaches a point. We'll get this a lot more later in the show, but coming up, to the Cowboys no longer need Ezekiel Elliott? That's next on FS1. You could always check out.